Before copying your content, you'll want to decide which shell to copy it to in Desire2Learn. You should have one with your name and possibly a course title on there. That particular shell will be completely empty. The one that is marked template, you may have a couple of those. Those will have the template structure of weekly learning modules and things of that nature. So you'll want to decide which one to put it in. The content that I've copied from the class already has a modular structure, so I'm going to copy it into a class that when I click on content, I have no structure at all. So this is where I'll be bringing the files over to. So what I want to do is, of course, click on content, and then I want to click on manage files over here on the side menu. And now what I'm going to want to do is click this green button that will give us the upload option. And I will browse for the file, and I know that it is on under my documents here in downloads. And here's the file here that is the backup. So I will open that, and then I will upload. We can see here that the file has arrived. Now this 52 megabyte file took approximately 14 to 15 minutes to upload, so be patient as it's coming in. We can see here now that the file has arrived. So we need to unzip this file, and if we click on the drop-down menu here, we can select unzip. Say yes. Now that procedure took under 2 minutes, so what we've got here are all of the files that we've brought over from the Blackboard class, and now we're ready to start organizing and rebuilding the class in Desire2Learn. The last thing we'll want to do in this section will be return to the Manage Files area. And in the Manage Files area, we are going to want to delete this 52 megabyte zip. So if I select that and then click on the delete and say yes. So now we're tidying up after ourselves as we go, and it really is the best way to keep a class from getting out of control.